I choose I. Recall some facts from the Brave Group. Choose Brave. Brave Group. And Artin. Artin representation. The Brave Group, BN on N strings, BN, has the presentation as the group with the generator sigma 1, sigma n minus 1, and the finite number of defining relations. Defining relations are two types. First relation is commutativity, and the second relation is the so-called long relation, it's relation of this type. And if we consider a Brave group as the object of combinatorial group theory, in this theory, then formulated three great problems, and the one of them is the so-called God problem.
I think it should be sigma I plus 1.
Oh, yes, thank you. Sorry. Plus 1. God problem. Let U and V are two words in the alphabet sigma 1 plus minus 1, so on sigma n minus 1 plus minus 1. And we must to decide, is it true that these words are equal in the Brave group? Is we have this equality is Brave group Bn. Or it's equivalent. We have a word V and we can transform this word using the defining relation of this group to another group. See, it's a purely combinatorial problem because it's not topological. And, of course, there are a lot of approaches for solution of this problem, and one of them construct a faithful representation of this group into some group where we can solve this problem. And we can use the Artin representation, theorem of Artin. He constructed a representation, I will denote it phi A. Its representation from the Brave group Bn into the group of automorphisms of Fn, where Fn is a free group with a free generating set x1 so on xn. And the action of this representation is the following. It's enough to define this representation only on the generators. And phi A sigma I is the following automorphism. Xi goes to the product xi plus 1 xi inverse, and xi plus 1 goes to xy. And all our generators are fixed. I will use this rule during my talk. And Artin proved that the kernel of this representation is trivial, that the kernel phi A is trivial, and this theorem gives solution for the God problem for the Brave group. It's the first application of Artin representation. And the second application, now we consider Brave group not only as a combinatorial object. Sorry? Now we can give a geometric interpretation for the braids. Geometric interpretation. We can define the so-called elementary braid for any generator sigma I. We construct the following braid. It's the braid in free space. where the string I and I plus 1 and all our strings are trivial, and we can define the multiplication on these elements. Also, we can define sigma I minus 1, and for every root in this alphabet U and V, we can construct geometric braid. And now, if we have this geometric braid, B, V, and B, U, we can formulate the topological problem about equivalence of this geometric braid. It means that there is an isotopy which fixes this plane, and transform one geometric braid to another geometric braid. And this topological problem is equivalent to a purely algebraic problem. U is equal V in the braid group BN. And we can go from the set of geometric braid to the set of links in free space. We can define the operation of closure. It's where I define B infinity. It's the union of all braid group BN, and it's equal to 2 infinity. And we define the map B infinity. We've had into the set of L. L is the set of links in free space of T. It's the map of the following type. If we have braid here, and we construct the closure of this braid. And any link, it's one manifold in free manifold. And we can define the group of link. If L is some link, then its group, I will denote it GL, it's the fundamental group of the complement A free minus A. And if we want to find the set of generators and relation for this group, we can use the same Artin representation. Next theorem of Artin, that we construct the map from the set of braid into the set of links. And Alexander proved that this is epimorphism. For any link, we can find some braid such that its closure is equivalent to this link. Hence, if L is some link, and beta is a braid in Bn for some, and such that its closure is equivalent to L, then this group GL is defined by the following group. We have generators x1, xn, and defining relation the following type. We consider the image of beta. Beta is automorphism, and x, this automorphism on the generators of free group, xi. Xi, it's some word in the free group, and this word is equal to xi. And I from 1 to n. Group of link is a strong invariant for the link. Or not, for example. It's well-known facts. And now I consider some general group, so-called virtual braid group. Second part of my talk. Virtual braid group. And its representation, groups and Eventual braid group was defined by Kaufman and Vladimir Valentinovich Vershinin, who found simplest set of defining relation, and this group is denoted by VBN, VBN, and it has the following set of generators, sigma 1, sigma n minus 1, these elements generate the braid group BN, and another set of generators, rho 1, so on, rho n minus 1. These elements generate the symmetric group SN. Hence, we have the following set of relations. Relations for braid group BN, relations for symmetric group, I will write relation BN, relations CN, and two types of so-called mixed relations. Mixed relations is the relation of this form. Sigma I rho j is equal to rho j sigma I if modulo I minus j more than 1, and relation of this type. Sigma I rho I plus 1 rho I is equal to rho I plus 1 rho I and sigma I plus 1. And also we can formulate the following general problem. Problem: construct a faithful representation of braid group, virtual braid group V, B, N into the group of automorphism some group G, where G is a good group, some good group. It means what we can, so what problem in this group, and also we have description of the group of automorphism for this group. We know some representation of this group VBN, maybe here, known representations. Representations. The first representation it was defined by Vershinin. I will denote it by phi v. It was representation of VBN into the same group out of FN. Because see, we have a representation for the generator sigma 1, sigma n minus 1. And we want to extend this representation only on the generators rho 1, rho n minus 1. But this is permutation. And hence, we can take that I will write V, phi V sigma I. It's the same as for Arkin representation sigma I. And phi v or rho I, it's the automorphism, it's permutation of two generators, xi and xi plus 1. We have this representation, but this representation is not faithful if n more or equal 3. We can say what the kernel phi v is not equal to 1 if n more or equal 3. Because the image of virtual braid group V, B, N, it's the so-called Violet braid group. Violet braid group. And it's the quotient of virtual braid group by some so-called forbidden moves. You see that if you write relation of this type, where instead two generators rho I will be two generators sigma I plus one and sigma I. When we don't have this relation in the group VBN, but we have one of this relation in this group WBN. Hence, this representation is not faithful, and it's interesting to...
No, what you have said means that kernel contains... what you have said means that this representation is well-defined for valid braid groups. That means that whatever virtual braid is trivial as well, that is mapped to one. But you haven't yet said anything about the fact that this is exactly isomorphic. The image is isomorphic in
the
Velvet braid.
No, see, because what is the Velvet braid group? The Velvet braid group is, by the definition, it's the set of automorphism of free group, such that the image of any generator is conjugation some to another generators. And we forget about the condition that this automorphism fixes the product x1, x2, xn. If we add this condition, we will have the representation, the image of the Artin representation. But now we have only the definition. Riemann-Rürki proved that in fact this group WBN is isomorphic to some subgroup of automorphism of free group. Okay, we see that this representation is not faithful, and we can try to construct some more general representation. And the first this representation was constructed by Олег Васильевич Мантуров.
Not by Олег Васильевич.
Oh, sorry, Василий Олегович Мантуров. Мантуров using topological approach and later Бардаков independently using algebraic approach. This representation of this type, I will denote its phi m b. VBN into the group of automorphism Fn plus 1, where Fn plus 1 is the free group with the new generator Xn and Y. And the action of phi mb on the sigma I is the same as for Artin representation sigma I. And here, instead of permutation, we take the following automorphism, rho I. It acts on the generators xi by the following. Xi goes to xi plus 1, conjugated by generators y inverse, and xi plus 1 goes to xi, conjugated by new generator y. And you can check that in this representation, we don't have in the kernel some so-called forbidden relations. And these two representations are extension of the classical Artin representation. We have Artin representation, and we construct to its extension. Now, there are another type of representation, which are not extension of Artin representations.
Fn is the variable group of the n times the function disk.
Unfortunately, not. We don't have good topological interpretation for this representation. Of course, we can give some interpretation, but it's not possible to use this representation, prove that it's faithful. And also, now we know that this representation is not faithful to, for n more or equal. Here I give a definition. I will denote f n n is the free product of free group Fn and free abelian group of rank M, Zm. And third representation, it was constructed by Silver and Williams. And they defined the representation phi as W, it representation from V D N into the group of all F N N plus 1, where this abelian group of rank Z N plus 1 is generated by element U0, U1, so on, UN. And the action of the generators is the following. On the generators, generator sigma n, sigma I, we have the following automorphism. Xi goes to the product Xi, Xi plus 1 Ui, and Xi in the power minus 1 U0 Ui plus 1. This is the conjugation by these elements, and Xi plus 1 goes to Xi conjugated by U0. And the action on the generator VSW sigma I, rho I, for the generator rho I, it's the same as the permutation. I will write that it's equal to phi V rho I.
It's the same as my multivariable version you haven't mentioned there, when I have many y's.
So
aren't they isomorphic? Isn't that isomorphic to the multivariable version of mine you haven't mentioned with many y's? When I have not just one y, but I conjugate by y with a certain index where the index is exactly the name of the strand.
But it's not automorphism. You can check that we don't have relations.
So I have an automorphism. Are they equivalent? Or
in which sense?
We have different groups.
This group is the free product of this type, and here we have only automorphism of Fn, Fn plus 1.
No. My multivariable version is an automorphism of F to N. So we have N different Ys. We have Y1, Y2, Y3, and so on. So I have F to N. So, and they have something abelian. So conjecturally, it may be.
I don't know. So I only know this result.
No. I have different y's, right? I have different y's.
Okay, you can check. I write this representation, second, and you can cut. Are we equivalent?
Yeah, and why do you write M?
Sorry, it's not me. It's the representation on Silver and Williams.
Yeah, but why do you write M and not N?
Because it's general notation. Later, I will use another indices here.
And where does this M come from?
Sorry?
I don't understand the sense of this M.
M is the, in this case, M is equal to N plus 1. In the next case, m will be equal to, and in the next step, it will be n. I give a general notation. Now you can use different letters m. That's all. Okay, this is the third and the fourth. It's the presentation of Boden plus some co-authors. You can see this name in the abstract, for example. And they constructed, I will denote this representation by VB. It's the representation of VBN into the group of automorphisms Fn2. Here we have three abelian group of rank 2. And this group, Z2, is generated by two elements, U and V. And the action is the following. Phi B of rho I. It's similar to this automorphism. Xi goes to Xi. Xi plus 1, Xi, and here only u in minus 1. And Xi plus 1 goes to Xi conjugated by u. And then, it's automorphism sigma I. And the phi b on the rho I, it's the automorphism of this type. It's permutation and conjugation. It's equal to E, B, rho. Okay, we have a free type of representation. We see that these two types are extension of Artin representation, and this representation is U in some sense. And the following question is arrived. Are they faithful or not? Unfortunately, the answer is no in general case. It was proved by Chterenthal, and I formulated his result. Theorem Chterenthal. He constructed some braid beta from group VBN such that this braid, before virtual braid group on four strings, and such that beta lies in the kernel of the representation phi M. And also, it's not difficult to prove that this braid lies in the kernel of all these representations. It lies in the kernel of phi s w, and also in the kernel of the representation. Hence, it's need to try to construct some new representation, which is better than the previous. It's the first question. The second question, also we can study not only the braid group, we can study so-called virtual links and virtual nodes. I recall the definition. Third part is virtual links. There are some approaches for the definition of virtual links. I use the more simple definition. We consider a diagram of some link, and we'll consider not only classical crossing, but also the virtual crossing. We have two types of crossings. Classical crossings and virtual crossings. But now it's only diagram. It's not topological object. It's diagram. Also, we can define the set of generalized Rademaster moves. I will denote, this is the VL, the set of virtual links. And we can formulate it the same problem as in the classical knot theory. It's classification of virtual links by the modulo of a generalizer in the master moves. Generalize ready master. Also, we can try to construct some invariants for these virtual links. And the following problem define a group of virtual link. In the classical case, we have a natural definition. It's fundamental group of complements. And using the Artin representation, we can only find the set of generators and defining relation. But now we don't have topological object. We have only combinatorial object. But we can use the following approach. Suppose that we have some representation P in virtual break group VBN into group of automorphism of some group G, where G is a group with a set of generators G1, GM. This is some finitely generated group, and we can try to construct the map from the virtual brain into the set of virtual links. We can use the same approach as in the classical case. We can define diagram for the virtual break through I. It's the diagram of the following type. Here the virtual crossing, and using the product of this elementary break, we can construct for any element from virtual break group from VBN some virtual links. Hence we have the map VB infinity, the same map closure, VB infinity, into the group of, into the set of virtual links. And we constructed this representation. And now if virtual link VL is the closure of some virtual break, it's the closure of virtual braid beta, where beta in the group VBN, we can define the group, I will denote it G with psi, G psi of beta. Psi is our representation in the sum group of automorphism, and the group of this braid, it's only the group which we construct using the braid. It's the group with the generators G1, so on, GM, and quotient by the relations. At first relation in the group G, because G is some group, and we add the relation of the following type, C beta GI is equal to GI for all I from 1 to M. But it's need to prove that this group is invariant of this virtual link. It's need to prove if two virtual links are equivalent, then this group will be isomorphic. And we can use these four representations, which we defined, to define this group. People defined the group for virtual link using these representations. For example, the first representation, and I use this representation.
Yeah, but you have to mention the Markov theorem more or less explicitly, because the Markov theorem for virtual rates is much more complicated than the Markov theorem in the classical case. And there are some virtual exchange moves. And, well,
I don't have Markov theorem in the general case, because I formulated the general approach. Here it's arbitrary group. And how you can prove that this group R is invariant, I don't know. It doesn't depend on the Markov theorem. Of course, when you consider the virtual break group, and you want to prove that this group is invariant, it need to use some generalization of Markov theorem. This generalization was proved by Seiichi Kamada and first, and after this was publication of Kaufman and Lombropoulos. We simplify this proof. But now it's not in this theorem. Okay, and if we consider the first representation and define GVA, is the so-called fundamental group. Fundamental group of Kaufman. Kaufman defined this group, and we can we can find this group using this representation. But unfortunately, this group, of course, it's proved that this group is invariant. But unfortunately, it's not strong invariant. Because if we consider virtual trefoil, GV, and here it's virtual trefoil, we know that this virtual trefoil is not trivial, but it has the same group as trivial node. And this is the group.
Sorry?
Yes, generalized randomizer moves is the following. We have three classical randomizer moves. We add three virtual randomizer moves. We add instead classical crossing, virtual crossing. And also we add so-called mixed randomizer moves. Mixed randomizer moves come from the mixed defining relation for virtual break group. It's a relation, it's move of the following type. We have one classical crossing and two virtual crossing. And this is equivalent to the... This is, okay. If we use the next representation, then it's not difficult to prove that in this case, group for virtual trefoil is not equivalent to the group of trivial node. Hence, this group is better, but we know that it's not enough for all cases. This is the second case, and also the people who introduce the Silver and Williams, for example, and also Boden with company, we study not only representations, we study the group which they construct, which they constructed using this representation, and study some property of virtual links and nodes. And it's interesting the following question. Is it possible to construct some general representation which generalize all previous representation, but it will be extension of the Artin representation? Because...
One small remark. Recently, Dror Bar-Natan gave us a Skype talk when he understood that we can charge only classical crossings, in the sense that for virtual crossings, we do just permutations and do not charge them at all. So that whatever we do at the virtuals, we can move it to classicals. So so all virtuals, when we put something more than just permutation. Virtual crossing can be replaced by.
Sorry, I don't know these results. What is it? It's interesting to construct some representation. It's interesting not only with, as application for to a virtual not fair. It's interesting for a virtual break group. And if you consider virtual break group, you can consider it as a combinatorial object, only using generators defining relations. And I formulated the main result. This is the theorem which is proved by Bardakov, Mikhalchishina. And Nishidim. It's possible to find in archive and the following theorem. Will exist a representation, I will write only V, from V, B, N into the group out F, N, N, such that the first, this representation is generalizes all the previous. Generalizes the previous. Known representation. The second, in some sense, it's better than the previous, because if we consider the element which constructs Chitrin type, then phi of B is not trivial. Where beta is Chitrin type element. Hence, this element does not lie in the kernel of our representation. But I don't know, is it faithful or not faithful. It's the second and the third that phi, if beta is some element from V, B, N, and beta some and beta prime some another element from V, B, M, such that their closure are equivalent as virtual links. Then the group G phi beta is isomorphic to the group G phi beta prime. Hence, we proved that this group is invariant of virtual links. Okay, that's